Before we go any further, I'd like real quick to say thank you to the staff here. They're excellent helping us get everything set up. These things don't just materialize, and we have to do a lot of coordinating for this type of thing. I'd like to thank our program coordinator, Ms. Logan Graham, as well as Robert Davesack. Where's Davesack? He's up there at the top. He's the guy that was in charge of making sure that all this stuff got in here, putting it where it needs to go, helping coordinate what needs to move when and whatnot. So Logan helped put the programs together, helps take care of coordinating a few other things, working with Dave Zach and working with the staff here in Stuart Theater to make sure that all these things happen. So thank you guys very much, all of you, for what you do. Otherwise, we could not be here doing what we do. Thank you. Our next word, I debated whether or not playing it first. A lot of times you either hear March first or last. They didn't want to do March last because when you hear the next piece, you'll understand why. Just really don't follow it with anything. And I don't know if Nebraska play anything after that. You'll find out. And first, we thought Temperance Steel was a better opener. So we are starting the second half of the concert with a John Philip Sousa march. John Philip Sousa is best known as the March King. Probably his best known is Stars and Stripes. I mean, that is our national march. He wrote it. John Philip Sousa has written many phenomenal marches. Well, the march that we're about to play is actually his first truly popular march. The Gladiator sold over 1 million copies. That was his first work to sell like that. I mean, you might think, 1 million copies, you're kidding. You have to think about it. They didn't have radio, videos, you know, all that stuff. None of that existed. So in the early 20th century, live performances were it. People are entertaining themselves and listening to these things on records. John Philip Sousa was a rock star, the first real rock star that we had in America when you think about it. So this is the first gold album, if you will, from America's first real rock star, John Philip Sousa.